Good afternoon. I am Jean Glasheen. Today is the solemnity of the holy body and blood of Christ. At this time, if you have a cell phone, please silence it or turn it off. If during the liturgy children need to use the restroom, we ask that they be accompanied by an adult. We extend a warm welcome to those of you who are visitors. The celebrant for this Mass will be Father Vaughan. In this gathering, we have been asked to remember Matthew Janus, Bernadette Bouchard, and Irene LaForge. Only one collection is taking up during Mass. Please place both your offertory donation and your donation for utilities in this single collection. Please use second collection envelopes found at the entrances for any check or cash donation made to the second collection. Now let us take these final moments to prepare ourselves to receive Jesus in the Eucharist and pray together our parish mission prayer. Through your Son, Almighty Father, we have received the mission to go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them and teaching them. Help each and every one of us at St. Patrick Parish to go, make, baptize, and teach, so that each person that we meet will fall in love with you and seek your love in the sacraments through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Good afternoon. Let us now join into worship by praising God with our opening hymn, number 558, Glory and Praise to Our God, number 558. Please stand.
Glory and praise to our God, who alone gives life to our days. Many are the blessings he bears to those who trust in his ways. We, the daughters and sons of him who builds the valleys and plains, praise the wonders our God has done in every heart that sings. Glory and praise to our God, who alone gives light to our days. Many are the blessings he bears to those who trust in his ways. In his wisdom he strengthens us like gold that's tested in fire. Though the power of sin prevails, our God is there to save. Glory and praise to our God, who alone gives light to our days. Many are the blessings he bears to those who trust in his ways. Every moment of every day, our God is waiting to save. Always ready to seek the lost, to answer those who pray. Glory and praise to our God, who alone gives light to our days. Many are the blessings he bears to those who trust in his ways.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit,
amen.
The grace and peace of God our Father, and of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you raise us to new life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you forgive us our sins. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you feed us with your body and blood. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand, the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us, for you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who in this wonderful sacrament have left us a memorial of your passion, grant us, we pray, so to revere the sacred mysteries of your body and blood, that we may always experience in ourselves the fruits of your redemption, who live and reign with God the Father in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of Deuteronomy. Moses said to the people, "Remember how for 40 years now the Lord your God has directed all your journeying in the desert, so as to test you by affliction and find out whether or not it was your intention to keep his commandments. He therefore let you be afflicted with hunger and then fed you with manna, a food unknown to you and your fathers, in order to show you that you are not by bread alone does one live, but by every word that comes forth from the mouth of the Lord. Do not forget the Lord your God, who brought you out of the land of Egypt, that place of slavery, who guided you through the vast and terrible desert with its seraph serpents and scorpions, its parched and waterless ground, who brought forth the water for you from the flinty rock and fed you in the desert with manna, a food unknown to your fathers." The word of the Lord.
Praise the Lord, Jerusalem, Alleluia. Praise the Lord, Jerusalem, Alleluia.
Zion, for he has strengthened the bars of your gates. He has blessed your children within you. Praise the Lord, Jerusalem. Alleluia. He has granted peace in your borders. With the best of wheat he fills you. He sends forth his command to the earth. Swiftly runs his word. Praise the Lord, Jerusalem. Alleluia. He has proclaimed his word to Jacob, his statutes and his ordinances to Israel. He has not done thus for any other nation. His ordinances he has not made known to them. Alleluia. Praise the Lord, Jerusalem. Alleluia.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, the cup of blessing that we bless, is it not a participation in the blood of Christ? The bread that we break, is it not a participation in the body of Christ? Because the loaf of bread is one, we, though many, are one body, for we all partake of the one loaf, the word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to the Jewish crowds, I am the living bread that came down from heaven. Whoever eats this bread will live forever, and the bread that I will give is my flesh for the life of the world. The Jews quarreled among themselves, saying, How can this man give us his flesh to eat? Jesus said to them, Amen, amen, I say to you, unless you eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, you do not have life within you. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood has eternal life, and I will raise him on the last day. For my flesh is true food, and my blood is true drink. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood remains in me, and I in him. Just as the living Father sent me, and I have life because of the Father, so also the one who feeds on me will have life because of me. This is the bread that came down from heaven. Unlike your ancestors who ate and still died, whoever eats this bread will live forever. The Gospel of the Lord. Today we celebrate Corpus Christi, the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, and it's a reminder to us of his presence, that he gives us his very body and blood, soul and divinity, his very being in the Eucharist. He gives us himself, not as a symbol, but in reality, under the form of bread and wine as a sacrament, true. But then again, when we look at the fact that Jesus came as a human. He was God, but he took on our humanity. He didn't look like God then either. He doesn't look like God when he comes to us under this form of bread. He humbles himself, but he is truly here. In this gospel we hear today, it's from the end of the Bread of Life discourse. Just after this, you know, people say, this is too much. Basically, they say, this guy is crazy. And Jesus has doubled down, says, no, it's not just that I'm saying this as a symbol or as a way of kind of getting your attention. He says, this is really who I am. This is really what I'm saying. You have to eat my flesh and drink my blood. And in fact, in the original Greek, he's using a different word than would normally be used for eating, the way we would eat anything, which could be taken symbolically. He actually uses it, this word trogo in the Greek, which means to gnaw or to chew, the way an animal chews. He says, there's a real fleshy eating going on here. And the people freak out, and they leave. And Jesus lets them go. What he does, he turns to the 12 and he says, do you also want to leave? Peter says, Lord, to whom shall we go? You have the words of eternal life. We've come to believe that you are the Christ, the Son of God. Do we believe? Studies show that in America, even those who go to Mass regularly, there's a high percentage that don't believe that what we do here at the altar, the bread and wine, become the very body and blood of Christ. People see it just as symbolic. But our faith for the last 2,000 years has been what Jesus said happens really does happen. That somehow, he makes himself present here under the form of bread and wine. We use this very complicated word, transubstantiation. And transubstantiation is basically saying there's a change of substance. That while the outward signs look the same, feel the same, taste the same, what it is changes at a very radical being underneath where we cannot see. But the grace is God has given us signs throughout the history of the church to help us believe that this is true. We have so many Eucharistic miracles throughout the history of the church. One of the miracles happened where a priest was celebrating Mass and he was really struggling and really, really didn't believe that this was really becoming the body of Christ. He's struggling with faith. Saying, I don't get it. I don't understand. I don't know how this can really be God. And God did a miracle for him of changing it into visible flesh. That as he was holding it as part of the Mass, the Eucharist became visible flesh. That was several hundred years ago, but that flesh is still here in the world today. I think it's in Lanciano, Italy. And people nowadays have gone and done studies on this, scientific studies. The church has actually chosen atheists to look at this because they wanted to make sure that it's not like saying, oh, well, you were a scientist, but you're a faith follower, so, you know, you are skewed. No, they took atheists to make sure that there would be no skewed results on this. And the result was what it is flesh. but not just flesh, flesh from a heart. And not just flesh from the heart muscle, but living flesh. This stuff that's been sticking around for 400 or 500 years. Scientists have said that's still alive. Impossible. But God did this as a miracle for us. This year, as we're in the midst of our Eucharistic revival throughout the United States, one of the saints that we have is Blessed Carlo Acutis. And Carlo Acutis, he's the first millennial to be raised to the altars. So Carlo Acutis loved to play video games. Carlo Acutis is younger than most of the people here in the church. He died in 2006, and he was 15 when he died. So you do the math, he's younger even than me. He was born after me, but he died very suddenly of leukemia back in 2006. He loved to play video games. He loved computers. And you look at some of these kids, and all they do is spend their time on the video games. And say, what's going to become of these kids? Well, there's a possibility, if they open themselves, that even they can become saints. So it's a pretty good thing. But we look, and here's this first millennial to be raised to the altars. And he had this incredible love for the Eucharist, even though his family didn't have any real devotion. But somebody had taught him that the Eucharist was really Jesus. And so whenever they'd pass, he'd make sure his parents went into the church. On vacations, they had some money, and so they'd take him to different places for vacations. And for vacations, they'd say, where do you want to go, Carlo? And he'd say, well, he lived in Italy, so I want to go up to this part of Italy to see this Eucharistic miracle, or this other part of Italy to see this other Eucharistic miracle. There are a lot of Eucharistic miracles in Italy. And so he'd travel all over Italy seeing the different Eucharistic miracles. Then he'd go back to class in school and talk, basically do show and tell. You know, what did he do? What did he learn? And try to draw his classmates into a greater understanding of the incredible gift that God was giving of showing he is present here. Eventually he realized this isn't good enough, because all he can reach is the people in his own class. And so he created this website, drawing in all these different Eucharistic miracles from all over the world, putting them in one place so that people can go and research that. A couple years ago, we had the fruit of that work in the Eucharistic miracle display come to our own parish center for a few days, if you had the opportunity to get over there and look through it. But this incredible gift where God shows us, do you see, it's really me. I'm really here. I want to stay close to my people. I have given you my very flesh and blood to eat and to drink so that you can have life. And the word in the Greek for life is not just ordinary life, but it's something more. It's eternal life. He wants us to be able to live forever. Do we believe this? This is one of these things where if we don't believe the Eucharist is what the church and Jesus says it is, if it isn't what we say it is, we are the worst people in the world. Because what we are doing is cookie worship. What we are doing is idolatry. And we should be stoned for doing what we're doing if it isn't what God says it is. If it isn't what Jesus says it is, if it isn't what the church says it is. But if what we do here is what Jesus says it is, what the church says it is, this is the greatest mystery in the world. That God would deign to humble himself to come and be in our presence, that we could receive him into us, that he would want that intimate union with us. There is no middle ground on this. If this isn't Jesus, we should all run out of here saying we're being idolaters. But if this is Jesus, everyone should be flocking to worship the King of Kings. Doesn't mean that we don't struggle with faith. Doesn't mean that we don't say, well, I believe, but I don't believe. Obviously, there's that man that was at the foot of the mountain of transfiguration that said to Jesus, I believe, Lord, help my unbelief. There's going to be struggles, and we might have to look for strength with that. But if we are actively not believing this, then we need to run out of here. But there's no room in the in-between saying, well, it's just a nice symbol. No, if this is just a symbol, what we're doing here is evil. Because we're worshiping what happens at this altar. But if it is Almighty God, this transforms everything. God, creator of heaven and earth, the one who's created the smallest quark in the atom to the largest star that's out there. God who's created the whole universe, the angels, chooses to come into union with you, with me. God chooses to be present to us so that any day, any time of day, we can come into that chapel 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, and spend time with the God of the universe in his very presence. I feel like Joshua here, where Joshua says to the Israelites, you can choose to run away or you can choose to follow the Lord. But he says, as for me and my house, I will serve the Lord. I am choosing the way of faith. And I bet many of you have done so as well. But if you've struggled, if you're saying, I don't really believe this, I invite you to take time and say, God, help me to believe. Help me to see if you are really present here. Maybe do the research in terms of looking up some of these Eucharistic miracles and saying, you know, what is this that the scientists are saying, not the people of faith, because the people of faith might be skewed, right? Because we have kind of an vested interest. But the people who are the atheistic scientists who are doing the studies on these, what are they saying about these Eucharistic miracles? Can you imagine? Let us ask Almighty God for that grace of faith, that when he says, this is my body, this is my blood, that we may believe his words to be true and come into the union with the God of the universe. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. The Lord God has satisfied our hunger from feeding our forebears in the desert to sending us living bread from heaven. Therefore, we offer our needs to God, trusting that our hunger will be satisfied.
For the church, that we, though many, may truly be one body, as St. Paul envisioned, nourished by the body and blood of Christ, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For elected leaders, that they may hunger for a just society, and that their hunger may drive them to work for justice for the least of the women, men, and children they represent, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For people of faith who fight to preserve religious liberty, may the Lord strengthen their resolve to hold firm in their witness, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all Catholics will adore the great gift of the Holy Eucharist given to them by Jesus Christ in the hands of his priest to nourish them with his body, and that the Holy Spirit will inspire many more to follow him, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us gathered here, that we may be a Eucharistic people, giving of ourselves and nourishing those around us, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the repose of the souls of Louis Purcell and all who have died recently, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the repose of the souls of Matthew Janus, Bernadette Bouchard, and Irene LaForge, and for all our beloved deceased, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the prayers of this assembly, and for all the prayers written in our parish book of intercessions, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. God of infinite generosity, we cry to you in our hunger, and you feed us with living bread. We cry to you now in our need, trusting in your lavish kindness. May the body and blood of your Son that we receive here today nourish us and inspire us to give of ourselves to others. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
His loving
brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Grant your church, O Lord, we pray, the gifts of unity and peace, whose signs are to be seen in mystery in the offerings we here present. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, almighty and eternal God, through Christ our Lord, for at the Last Supper with his apostles, establishing for the ages to come the saving memorial of the cross, he offered himself to you as the unblemished Lamb, the acceptable gift of perfect praise. Nourishing your faithful, by this sacred mystery, you make them holy, so that the human race, bounded by one world, may be enlightened by the one faith and united by one bond of charity. And so we approach the table of this wondrous sacrament, so that, bathed in the sweetness of your grace, we may pass over to the heavenly realities here foreshadowed. Therefore, all creatures of heaven and earth sing a new song in adoration, and we, with all the host of angels, cry out and without end acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
To you, therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition, through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Peter, our Bishop, and all those who, holding to the truth, hand on the Catholic and Apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants and all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer you this sacrifice of praise, or they offer it for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. In communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, and all your saints, we ask that through their merits and prayers in all things, we may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family. Order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands. And with eyes raised to heaven to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands. And once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith.
Save us,
save us,
Savior of the world, by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ, your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty, from the gifts you have given us, this holy victim, this pure victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you are pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the just, the sacrifice of Abraham our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us, who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son, may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing. Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with the sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servants, who, though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share in fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, and all your saints, admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom,
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Taste and to see, taste and to see the goodness of the Lord. Oh, taste and to see, taste and to see the goodness of.
Taste and see, taste. and see the goodness of the Lord, of the Lord. Glorify the Lord with me together. The Lord, and He answered me from all my troubles, He set me free. Taste and see the good.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, we pray, that we may delight for all eternity in that share in your divine life, which is foreshadowed in the present age by our reception of your precious body and blood, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. We have nothing to announce that's coming up. However, one thing that I did hit me today, just for those of you who have been wondering, today is June 10th, 2023. 10 years ago, I came to the parish. So I've been here now 10 years. I can say, with all honesty, you have all put up with me twice as long as any other parish ever. So thank you for the 10 years that you've given to me, and may you still have the stamina to keep up with putting up with me as long as the bishop decides to keep me here.
Also, Father, happy anniversary on your ordination.
Thank you.
20 years.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace.
Thanks.
The prayer to St. Michael. St. Michael, the archangel, defend us in battle. Be our defense against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, thrust into hell Satan and the other evil spirits who prowl about the world for the ruin of souls. Amen.
Please join us in singing the song that sends us forth, number 732, Alleluia, Sing to Jesus, number 732.
Questions high.